Psalm 1. This psalm was placed first as a preface to the rest. From its exciting, so concise, yet so fulsome, to a deep study of the Holy Scriptures generally, and consequently of the Book of Psalms as a part of them, and inviting to a due supplication of their precepts for the governance of the heart and conversation by their encouraging promises, which imply all attainable happiness, and by the influence of the threatenings, which denounce that there is no peace for the wicked. Measure of alternate lives of 8 and 6 souls. But the song was to the congregation: blessed is the man that walketh not, blessed is the man that walketh not where impious counsel guides, nor in the way of sinners stands, nor sits where scorn presides. But in the law of God the Lord is placed, his chief delight, and on that law he meditates in every day and night. He shall be like a tree that is planted the river near, that in its season doth its fruit luxuriantly bear, his leaf too neither wither shall, nor in its verdure fade, and whatsoever work he doth shall prosperously succeed. But the ungodly are not so. They, like the chaff, are found, which the wind driveth far away and scattereth o'er the ground. Therefore, in judgment's awful day, the ungodly shall not stand, nor sinners when assembled is of righteous souls the band. For of the righteous doth the Lord know and approve the way, but that of all ungodly men shall utterly decay. Psalm 2. Eminently prophetical. This psalm appears to have been when crowned with victory and placed triumphant on the sacred hill of Zion. It is cited, however, by the apostles, who with one voice declared it to be prophetically descriptive of the exaltation of God and of the opposition raised against them by both by Jew and Gentile. Pride stand up, and rulers join in envious counsel against the Lord and his anointed one, saying, asunder let us break their ignominious bands, and cast away from us their cords that fetter the sour hands. of everlasting God shall them into derision turn. Then in his wrath he unto them shall speak, and them shall vex in his displeasure, and their minds with sorest fear perplex. Yet have I on the holy hill of my loved Zion set my king, and in his hand have I dominion's sceptre put. Peace to the congregation prophetically of the Messiah. The Lord's decree I shall declare, which he revealed to me. Thou art my son, said he, this day have I begotten thee. Ask of me, and as heritage I'll the heathen give, and the earth's utmost parts shalt thou for thy possession have. Them with a rod of iron thou shalt rule, and surely crush thou like a potter's vessel too, shalt them in pieces dash.